Ah, birds, the Mr. Men and Little Misses have marveled at the many winged creatures that take to the sky. Some will do just about anything to get a close-up view of a bird, while others are happy to have the birds come to them. Of course, there are those who are very serious in their love for these creatures. But who are we to judge? There's little doubt that the good people of Dillydale respect their feathered friends, even those making noise in their own backyard.
Is that really necessary? No, you leave me no choice.
Hi there, Mr. Quiet!
If you don't mind, I'm meditating. Just sitting here nice and quiet, alone with my thoughts.
Boy, that bird is really loud. I could hear him all the way over in my yard. I don't know how you can relax with all that noise. Well, I'd better get back to my little tree. They say talking to your plants helps them grow. I'll let you know if it works. See ya! So, how do you like it here, little tree? Are you getting enough sun? Not too much sun. At least not without some sunscreen.
Some thanks.
Look, Mr. Quiet, talking to your tree really works. Hey, since your tree is gone, why don't you take mine? It even comes with birds, and some of them are going to have baby birds. I love the sound of baby birds.
You've heard her sing, but never quite like this.
Little chirping bluebird, what do you say? Just how many worms can you eat in one day?
It's Miss Sunshine's Bird Songs, her first collection of songs dedicated to our feathered friends.
It seems like only yesterday that you were just an egg.
With 10 original songs, you won't be disappointed.
When your beak is your backpack, there's nowhere you can go. Oh.
And the number one dance hit, Party of Pink.
There's a party going on, and it's not what you think. A flamingo fight, BS, a feathered only in pink.
So buy your very own Miss Sunshine Bird Songs today. And when I say it for the birds, I mean it.
You're watching Dillydale Television.
Hello and welcome to the Tickle Expert. I'm your host, Mr. Tickle. I know everything there is to know about tickling, and I'm Mr. Bum! And today, we're here to show you the different ways to tickle a bird.
Tickle a bird? I thought we were tickling watermelons today.
Yeah, that could happen too, but mostly we're here to tickle birds. Let's get started, shall we?
No! Okay!
No! Every different bird needs a different kind of tickle. Take that parrot, for instance. When tickling parrots, you should never let them see you coming. Go and give them a tickle, Mr. Bump.
Polly want a tickle?
Parrots might act like they don't want to tickle, but deep down they really do. That's why it's best to use the sneak attack tickle. See how simple it is? Tickling turkeys can be kind of tricky. That's why I invented the gobble gobble tickle. Give it a try, Mr. Bump. worry. The Gobble Gobble Tickle never fails.
Gobble Gobble?
Well, almost never fails. When performing the Gobble Gobble Tickle, it's very important to sound like a real turkey. Of course, the most dangerous bird of all is the large hooked beak eagle. When it comes to tickling them, you just have to be brave. Show them, Mr. Bump.
Actually, about that brave part...
But you're the bravest guy I know.
I am?
Sure.
Well, since you put it that way... Whoa!
That eagle really needs a tickle. Well, that's all the time we have for today. I'd like to thank my co-host, Mr. Bump. For tuning in. And remember, anyone can be a bird tickling expert. All you have to do is tickle.
Stop! No! Stop! Ow!
A popular pastime in Dillydale is bird watching. Everyone loves being out in the fresh air, witnessing nature at its finest. Well, almost everyone.
Mr. Fussy, you don't know what you are doing. We have been walking all day.
Yeah, the cheese in my sock is starting to melt.
Have patience, gentlemen. The giant blue-bellied buzzard is a very shy creature.
Oh, Mr. Fussy, why are they called giant?
Because, Mr. Strong, they're big.
No kidding.
Mr. Rude, I don't mean to complain, but you didn't mention anything about giant when you invited me along.
It must have slipped my mind.
Can I borrow your binoculars, Mr. Fussy?
Oh, very well. But do take note that they are perfectly clean. I expect to get them back that way.
I'll do my best.
Giant!
Let's keep our voices down. Loud noises make the giant blue-bellied buzzards very angry.
I see him! Up there! Shazam! Those are some big buzzards!
Let me see. Ugh, Mr. Messy, what did you do to my binoculars?
I don't know.
Why is it that you are completely unable to respect other people's things? I have a good mind to...
That buzzer's got Mr. Fussy.
I, for one, am glad he is gone.
Well, that was fun. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Oh, I can't leave now, Mr. Nervous. We have to rescue Mr. Fussy.
No, we should go home. Mr. Fussy would have wanted it that way.
Mr. Strong's right. He's gonna need our help. Unless Mr. Fussy wants to spend the rest of his life as a bird.
To each his own.
I don't know. I think he needs us. We're coming, Mr. Fussy.
Good gracious. She thinks I'm one of them. Is that really necessary? No. How utterly revolting. Help! Somebody save me! No!
This is actually kind of fun.
I'll give you fun.
Mr. Rude!
Oh, sweet mercy!
Thank heavens. No, please, no! I don't have wings. I'll fall right to the ground. Please, Mother!
I got you.
Thank you, Mr. Strong.
Good thing this route was secure enough to hold us both. Aw, pickles.
Get off me, you big buffoons. Thank goodness for friends. To think what could have become of me if you hadn't come to my rescue. Who knows? Maybe you would have learned to lay an egg.
How about we all go get some ice cream? My treat.
That's what I'm talking about.
As another fun-filled day of bird watching comes to a close, the Mr. Men and Little Misses restock their bird feeders, fill their bird baths, and leave out a few worms as a way of showing their appreciation for their fine feathered friends of Dillydale.